This tutorial shows how to test the normality assumption as a requirement for the paired samples t-test in SPSS. First question. What has to be approximately normally distributed? The residuals of the test variable. Residuals are the difference between your measurements for each individual. You have to, of course, calculate that. Go to transform, compute variable. The name of the difference goes into target variable. For instance, use res, residuals, difference, or just diff. The numeric expression on the right will be the calculation itself. In my case, score 1 minus score 2. You can of course reverse it to your liking, since we only look at the distribution, not the absolute values. After calculation, you will get a new variable in your dataset that will now be tested for normal distribution. There are three possible ways for this. An analytical test like the Shapiro-Wilk or Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, a histogram or a QQ plot. The Shapiro-Wilk test and especially the Kolmogorov-Smirnov tests are 1. Oversensitive to unimportant deviations from normal distribution in large samples, and 2. Lack power in small samples. This is a phenomenon for all analytical tests, for which you can find a source in the video description. A QQ plot is the easiest to interpret, therefore we continue creating one for the residuals. Go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Explore. Put your newly calculated residuals in the dependent list box. Next, go to Plots and deselect Stem and Leaf. If you want, you can request a histogram on top. More importantly, check the box for normality plots with tests. Only this option will create a QQ plot. The tests that go along with this will be ignored. You will get plenty of tables and graphs now. I already mentioned that it will be in your interest more often than not to ignore the tests for normality, especially with large samples and resulting type 1 errors. Focus on the normal QQ plot. The dots represent the observations and the line the perfect normal distribution. Therefore, the distances between the dots and the line should be minimized. There will be acceptable deviations, especially on the edges of the distribution, meaning the upper right hand corner and the lower left hand corner. For my example, there are no deviations that are worth mentioning, and I can calculate the paired samples t-test now, which is shown in the following video. If you, however, cannot observe an approximate normal distribution, you should use the paired sample Wilcoxon test instead, or apply bootstrapping to your paired samples t-test.